My dear students, this is Omkar here. I welcome you to the digital learning platform by Shri Guru Sudhindra College. This video is the continuation part of your chapter Liquidation of Companies, and this video contains three major problems on liquidation. Kindly note one important thing that all the explanations in this video are made as simple and easy as possible to conserve your data of the day and reserve your time for other videos, and also for preserving the videos for regular access. Yes, dear students, let us solve one problem. This page has one complete question and problem as well as notes below. So let us study it once. Okay, so see here, one company, timid company, went into voluntary liquidation on 31st, on which date the capital consists of as follows. The company has the following capital. Capital structure is given here. See, 5008% preference shares are there in this company, and each preference share is costing rupees 10. Okay, then 10,000 equity shares are there, and the price per the share is rupees 10. Okay, the assets are realized. Assets are realized means assets are sold. Okay, the expenses of liquidation is given. Correct? No, expenses of liquidation is rupees 2000. So during the process of liquidation, 2000 rupees is incurred as expenses of liquidation. Then there are unsecured creditors in this company, that is 34,000 rupees are there, and that unsecured creditors are including 3,000 preferential creditors. See here, preferential creditors are the part of unsecured creditors. Okay, done. Yes, the liquidator's remuneration was fixed. Okay, liquidator is to be paid. No, so for them, for him, the liquidator, the remuneration is fixed. 4% commission is to be given. On what? 4% on assets realized. The assets sold item, the amount will be there. No, on that you have to pay the liquidator the commission of rupees 4%. Another commission he is entitled, that is 2% commission. Okay, on what you have to pay? The amount distributed to shareholders. Here, which shareholders, it is not mentioned. That means shareholders means commonly preference and equity shareholders, both shareholders. It is not specified here which type of shareholders. That means both shareholders. Okay, so you have to give him 2% commission again, second commission, on what? The amount distributed to shareholders. So this is the question. Now then it is given one important note, that preference shares carry preferential right. You know that preference shareholders are carrying their preferential rights. They have to pay first. Okay, whether in terms of dividend or capital, you have to pay them first. Another important thing is given here. Note that there is no arrears of dividend. So there is no pending dividend with concern to preference shares. Okay, so this is the question. So now let us see the answer. Okay, see, now the answer is here. Let us understand the answer one by one. So first you have to see whatever the receipts there, that you have to write in the receipt side. Correct? No, left hand side. So assets realized, assets sold. Correct? No, assets sold or assets realized amount will be there. So it is 80,000 worth rupees. 80,000 assets are sold and 80,000 rupees collected at the receipt side. Now you have to pay this 80,000 rupees in the payment side. So you have to see any other secured loans are there that you have to pay. Those problems we have solved in the classes. Hope you got that. Secured creditors will be there. From them you have to pay. Then other additional, any other receipts are there that you have to take it off. It is there. Such problems are solved already in the classroom sessions. You go through it once, and also while solving this liquidator's final statement of account, be with your format. Okay, first understand the format, then you begin with this. And also you solve those problems which were solved during the class hours completely. You make it perfect, then you come to this problem, right? Okay, so now payment is to be done. So see here, what are the payments can be done? That payment is to be done in a priority basis. You know that different payments will be there and it should be paid in priority basis. So first you have to pay liquidation expenses here given. Okay, it is there in the problem above. Liquidation expenses 2000, it is there right here. See, expenses of liquidation amounted rupees 2000, it is paid here. One thing, second thing you have to pay is liquidator's remuneration. Liquidator is entitled for the commission, for him you have to pay remuneration. And what is the nature of remuneration there? 4% on what? See here, first commission is 4% commission on assets realized, correct? No, yes, assets are realized, that is worth of rupees 80,000, here it is there. And on 80,000 you have to pay him 4% commission. You are paying here, okay, that amounts to 3200. Another commission you have to pay on 2% commission, that is on amount distributed to shareholders. So how much amount is distributed to shareholders, you don't know that. You have not distributed it yet. You are paying here, correct? No, at this point you are going to pay the shareholders at last. You don't know what amount you are going to pay, so you have to leave this blank. Now right now it, you cannot calculate it, so leave this particular amount blank. And see what are the different payments are to be done in a preferential manner. So then you have to pay preferential creditors, correct? No, for that, before paying each item, you have to see this 80,000 amount. Out of 80,000 you are paying. So one by one amount, wherever you are paying, you have to see whether the amount is remaining or not. That you have to see. So see here, first you have paid 2000, then you are paying, you have paid 3200 now. Then you don't know this amount, you cannot calculate it right now, correct? No, you are keeping it aside. So leave blank and continue with the next amount which is to be paid, that is preferential creditor. For them you have to pay. How much you have to pay? See here, 3000 amount is there. No, preferential creditors are to be paid. For them you are paying 3000. Then you have to see next item is to be paid, that is unsecured creditors you have to pay. So unsecured creditors, they are 34000 amount worth, isn't it? So for them you have to pay. And one thing you have to note here, that this 3000 preferential creditors are including in unsecured creditors, correct? No, so for that reason you have paid preferential creditors already here. So remaining 34000 minus 3000, that is 31000 you have to pay here. Okay, now you have paid all the creditors. Now next preferential people, they are your preference shareholders you have to pay. You have to see what the amount remains now. So see here, out of 80,000 you have paid 2000 3200 4000 3000 31000. Then you have to say what amount remains. So now the amount which is to be payable are with concern to shareholders. For them you have to pay now. So two types of shareholders are there: preference shareholders and equity shareholders. First you have to pay preference shareholders. So how much amount remains there you have to see before paying, correct? No, so now you have to check the what balance is remaining 80,000 minus 2,000 minus 3,200 minus 3,000 you have paid till now, and also 31,000. Then some amount remains, correct? No, and that is to be distributed to preference shareholders first. So preference dividend is to be paid. Now it is given here no arrears of dividend, so dividend is not to be payable again. So now the preference shareholders, you have to pay the what the amount remains, that you have to see here. Note is given. Hope you have calculated there in your rough notebook. You just calculate these pattern of payment. Okay, 80,000 minus 2,000 minus 3,200 minus 3,000 minus 31,000. One amount will come. That is the amount payable to shareholders now. So see here, before paying them, now your particular amount, whatever you are deducting, 80,000 minus 2,000, 3,200, 3,000, 31,000. You are deducting it. Now you have 40,000 in your hand. Correct, no? So now this 40,800 rupees is to be paid. And this is the amount before payment to preference shareholders. You have to pay commission also, correct, no? And see, the commission criteria is 2% you have to pay on the amount distributed to shareholders. So before paying to shareholders, you have to pay commission now. So for that reason, you have to calculate commission on what amount now? 40,800 remaining balance. This particular 40,800 you have to pay to your shareholders. So before paying, you have to calculate the amount. How to calculate that? So you have to use the formula. You know that in the notebook during our before lockdown period, in the classroom session, we have two formulas. We have taken it down, isn't it? That is, one formula, when the money is sufficient to pay, then you have to apply different commission calculation formula. When you don't have money sufficient to pay to the remaining people, then on that, if you want to calculate commission, that you have to use different formula. So those formula you should know. So now the commission, the amount, the commission is to be calculated on the amount distributed to shareholders, correct, no? So on which you have to calculate the commission. So the commission is to be calculated now on 40,800. That is the amount remaining now. So, but the money you have to pay so much now. See here, 5,000 into 10 preference shareholders are to be paid. So 5,000 into 10 amount you have to pay. Then 10,000 into rupees 10 you have to pay to the equity shareholders. So you don't have money to pay. That much money is not there. So the amount for the distribution is not sufficient. For that reason, you have to calculate the formula. This one, see here. You have to calculate the commission by using formula 40,800. The money remains here into 2 divided by 102. Generally, the commission calculation formula is 2 divided by 100. Correct, no? Here in this situation. But you are going to apply the formula 2 divided by 102 here. Why? Because when the money is not sufficient, you have to use this formula. 2 divided by 100 plus 2. You have to do. So here money is not sufficient. For that reason, you are going to use the formula. See here. And that particular commission would be here. 2%. Correct, no? So 800 rupees will be the commission that you are going to add up here and take it into outer column. Done. Now what remains now after paying 800 out of 4,800? 40,000 rupees remains. So preference shareholders, for them you have to pay 5,000. See here, 5,000 into 10 you have to pay. That means 50,000 rupees you have to pay, but you don't have that much money. and you are just paying 40,000 now. So this way you have to calculate. That means your 80,000 whatever collected money is to be distributed one by one in a priority basis. And while priority basis, you may need to calculate different commissions here. And during calculation of commission, sometimes when the money is not sufficient, you have to use this formula. Clearly, the theory related item concerned to this is written or given to you already in during the class hours. So note it. So now only you can pay up to preference shareholders, because the money is over here. 40,000 money was remaining and you have paid it to preference shareholders. And for preference shareholders, you had to pay rupees 10, correct? No, because 5,000 preference shares were there and each preference share was costing rupees 10. Now you can pay only 40,000. That means 5,000, yes, 40,000 rupees remaining, and this 40,000 divided by 5,000, so that equals to rupees 8. Correct, no? So here you can only pay rupees 8, but their investment is 10. And next concern to your these equity shareholders are there. So for them you cannot pay the amount. So see here, the equity shareholders do not get the amount. Moreover, no calls be made since they are fully paid. And also here, no pending calls. Correct, no? If any pending calls are there, you would have received here. Those money can be collected here. But such money cannot be collected. Equity shares which are fully paid. So note this. So this way, this particular problem is solved. I will share this snapshot to you through the groups. You can also get that. Okay. So now let us move on to one next form problem on the liquidation chapter. So let's see here. Okay. See, yes, the Shadi Limited went into voluntary liquidation. One company is there and it went into voluntary liquidation. And its assets are realized in cash. Assets are sold, you have received 3,40,000. Then the company is having unsecured creditors, right? Unsecured creditors are there. And the amount is 50,000. And these unsecured creditors are also having involved 16,000 preferential creditors are there. This means these 6,000 preferential creditors are the part of unsecured creditors. Note it, important thing. Then the company has preference shares. 10,000 preference shares are there, 8%, and the price of each preference share is 10 rupees. Arrears of dividend for 1 year. See here, this is important thing. In previous problem, there were no arrears. Now in this problem, 1 year dividend is pending. Arrears means pending. Then the company is also having equity shares. 20,000 equity shares are there. 6 rupees paid. See here, important thing. 10 rupees is the price and only 6 rupees is paid. So 20,000 equity shares are there. Okay. Then the company is having P&L account, general reserve. Generally, this P&L account and general reserves balance will not come for any calculations in this liquidation chapter. Okay. Noted. This is given for confusion purpose. So you need not to get too confused with these things. So note the important thing, that P&L account and general reserves will not be taken for calculation anywhere. So next paragraph wise items are given. Let us check it. the liquidator is entitled to a remuneration. Liquidator remuneration you have to pay, that is 4% on realization of assets. Correct? Okay. Assets realized is here 3,40,000, on which you have to pay 4%. Another commission is also there. For 2% commission you have to pay on the distribution to unsecured creditors. So for unsecured creditors you are going to pay amount. On that amount they are demanding 2% commission. They, in the sense liquidator, he is demanding 2% commission on that also. Then the expenses of liquidation is there, correct? So 7,400 you have to pay that. Then the preference shareholders have preferential rights, that you know that. It is a common sentence, will be there in each problem. So preference shareholders will be having their preferential rights generally compared to equity shareholders on getting capital and dividend. Correct, no? Yes. Another important thing that it is given, that when they have also right to receive 1/4 of the surplus remaining. Surplus means whatever the amount which is remaining after the distribution of all type of priority persons. That means including equity shares. After paying equity shares, the last person, correct? So after paying the equity share holder also, if you have any more balance, some more amount is remaining, that is called a surplus. So generally it is distributed to equity shareholders only, but it is in this particular problem preference shareholders also have the right. How much right? How much ratio of right? 1/4 of the surplus they want, they are demanding, and it is agreed. So same way the things follows. Prepare the liquidator's final statement. Okay, so let us see the problem is here. Let us have a look at this once. Okay, right. First you have to see the amount which is to be collected or in at the receipt side. So 3,40,000 assets realized, it is there, you have collected it. Okay, 3,40,000, take it down. And also take one rough sheet and note the pattern of payments. Okay, now you have collected 3,40,000 minus next payment, minus next payment. Like this way you have to go on writing so that you can get the remaining amount after paying all these people, so that you can check whether the money is remaining or not. So for that thing, it is very important to take a note of that pattern of payments, for whom you are paying and what the amount remains. All those deductions you have to take it in a rough side. Okay, so note it. So now, okay, first thing you have to pay that, the liquidation expenses. It is there in the problem, clearly it is mentioned, correct? Liquidation expenses are there. Okay, here it is there, see, 7,400. Okay, first thing you have to pay that. Then liquidator is entitled for remuneration, that is 4% on assets realized. So assets realized amount is 3,40,000, on which 4,000 is to be paid, that will be 13,600 you are paying. Then next remuneration, 2% on the amount distributed to unsecured creditors. Unsecured creditors, how much you are paying them, you don't know that. You have not paid yet, correct? No, unsecured creditors you have to pay now. So you don't know this balance. You cannot calculate this balance right now. You have to check whether the amount is remaining. And if amount remains, how much amount can be paid to them, you have to see it. Correct, no? For that reason, you have to wait. So leave that particular thing and move forward. Next person to whom you have to pay, that preferential creditors you have to pay. So how many preferential creditors are there? How much amount is there? You have to check. Correct, no? Preferential creditors. Okay. See here. The preference shareholder, okay. Where is preferential creditors? See, here it is. Okay. 50,000 preferential creditors amount is there. And out of which, unsecured creditors amount is 50,000, out of which 6,000 is preferential creditors. That means this 6,000 is included in this particular 50,000. Now come here to this main point. So you have to pay the commission 2% on the unsecured creditors amount. Correct? No. That means 50,000 rupees. Unsecured creditors, 50,000 rupees on which you have to pay the commission. Okay. Then you have remaining balance with you. 3,40,000 is there. No. Here collected balance. You have paid this much. Only this much. Money is remaining. Then you can pay to your preferential creditors and unsecured creditors also. So 50,000 rupees is there. First you have to pay preferential creditors 6,000. You can pay, money is there, isn't it? Unsecured creditors also you can pay, that is 44,000. So you can pay this 50,000. Yes, then you can pay the commission also. Why you have to wait before paying these, that you cannot calculate the commission? Only reason that if the money is insufficient, then you have to use different formula, that you know that. Correct? No. Commission calculation formula in two scenarios. One, when the money is insufficient, when the money is sufficient. In such two cases you have different two formulas to calculate the commission. Okay, right? So now preferential creditors you paid, unsecured creditors also you paid. Now then you have to check the whether money is remaining or not. How to check? 3,40,000 minus 7,400 minus 13,600 minus 1,000, then 6,000, 44,000. Yes, if money remains you have to pay. Yes, preference shareholders, how much you have to pay? That, see here, 10,000 preference shareholders, that amounts to 1 lakh. 1 lakh rupees you have to pay. Yes, you have 1 lakh rupees, then you can pay 1 lakh rupees. It is paid here. 1 lakh rupees is paid, means 1 lakh rupees you have. Then dividend is pending, arrears, correct? No. 1 month, 1 year arrears pending amount is there. See here, it is given clearly. Okay, see here, arrears of dividend for 1 year, 8%. 8% is the percentage of dividend, correct? No. Then 8% of 1 lakh, that much amount is pending, that is yearly amount which is being arrears. So that you have to pay. Arrear dividend is there, 8,000. Then next you have to pay equity shareholders. You have to check again whether the money is remaining after paying this one, these people. So 3,40,000 minus 7,400, this amount and all those, these amount, preference dividend also you have paid. Now you have to pay equity shareholders. You have to check whether that much money is there or not. Correct? No. Yes, I think you may have that much money. See there once, how much money you have to pay to equity shareholders. 20,000 equity shares are there. Rupees 6 is paid. Correct? No. 20,000 into rupees 6. 1,20,000 rupees you have to pay to your equity shareholders. You have that much balance and you have paid here. You can pay that. Then if again money remains, I think the money remains again, you just note it, calculate it. You have to calculate it, this particular nature of payments. 3,40,000 minus 7,400, 13,600, 1,000, all those things. Then you have money again remaining. So that much money, how much money remains there again? Maybe 40,000 rupees you have. Correct? No. That is called as surplus. So 3,40,000 and all these amounts. So 40,000 remains, that is called as surplus, and that particular surplus is divided here. See here, preference shareholders, they have right, correct, no, 1/4 of the surplus they want, and they have the right. So for that reason, 1/4 of 40,000 you have to pay to your preference shareholders. How to calculate that? 40,000 into 1/4. So whatever remains after that is the 3/4. So 3/4 is to the equity shareholders. So that means your surplus, whatever remains, 40,000 rupees, that is shared among your two shareholders, preference shareholders and equity shareholders. Generally, it is for equity shareholders, but now they have preserved their rights. 1/4 share of the surplus is to be given to them. It is their right. It is according to this problem. So for that reason, you have paid them. That is 40,000 into 1/4. So remaining whatever 30,000 is there, you have to pay to your equity shareholders. So same thing here, note this important thing, calculation related things, notes are there, note it. Preferential calculation, preferential creditors are included in unsecured creditors, yes, correct. And for the calculation of commission also, see here, during the calculation of commission, you have to include, we have included it, correct, no? But you, for the other problem also, you should note that these preferential creditors and unsecured creditors, they should be taken 6,000 plus 44,000 for the calculation of commission. Okay, and P&L account general reserve balances are not considered anywhere in the liquidation problem. So note this important thing. So I will share this particular page picture also in your group. You can have it and note down the problem. Let us move on to next problem. Yes, so this is one simple problem again. You have to see once. Unlucky Limited went into voluntary liquidation on this particular date, and their capital structure is as follows. Okay, see here, the company has 10,009% preference shares of rupees 10 each. Preference shares are there, 10,000 preference shares are there, and each costing rupees 10, and the percentage of dividend is 9%. And the company is having equity shareholders also, 20,000 equity shares, rupees 10 is the price of the share, and both are fully paid. Okay, yes, the assets realized, 2,76,000 assets are sold. The expenses of liquidation is there, 1,320. Then unsecured creditors are there, 35,000. And these unsecured creditors are including preferential creditors. As usual, since the two problems, the same thing, same type of sentences are were there, no? Correct. So unsecured creditors are there of rupees 35,000, and these 5,000 preferential creditors are included in the 35,000. The liquidator is entitled for the commission, 3% commission he want on assets realized. Okay, another commission also he is charging, 2% commission he want again on what? On the amount distributed to equity shareholders. While distributing to equity shareholders, you should note this particular commission, you should calculate that. Preference dividend was paid up to 31st 12, that means dividend is unpaid. 2008 up to 2008 31st 12 it is paid, so that means 1 year, 2009, see here, correct, up to 2009. Yes, you have to pay 1 year pending dividend, correct? Preference shares carry preferential rights. Okay, that is as usual. Preferential rights they will be having always. Now, the preparation of liquidator's final account. Now, let us come to receipt side. First, we have to see how much money is received out of assets realized. Is clearly mentioned 2,76,000, correct? So now you have to pay one by one preferential payments. First, you have to pay expenses of liquidation. It is there here. That is where it is given. 1 lakh. Yes, here 1,320 rupees. Correct. Yes, you are going to pay it. You can pay. You have money. Next, then you have to pay remuneration. That is 3% commission on assets realized. Assets realized amount is here, on which you have to calculate 3% commission. Yes, you can calculate. Then another commission is there, 2% on the amount distributed to equity shareholders. But you don't know this, how much money you are going to distribute it to equity shareholders, you don't know. So you have to wait. Don't write this, leave this second commission one. Okay, yes, leave. Then you can see, you have to see money. If money is remaining, you have to pay next. So 2,76,000 minus 1,320 minus 8,280. Yes, you have money, correct? Yes, next payment person is, yes, they are preferential creditors. For them you have to pay. How much you have to pay? See here, 5,000 preferential creditors are there, and unsecured creditors also there, and this 5,000 is included in unsecured creditors, 35,000, correct? No. And first you have to pay preferential creditors. So preferential creditors you can pay, 5,000 rupees is there. Then next priority, unsecured creditors, you can pay, 30,000 rupees is there, correct? No. Now again see how much money remains. 2,70,000, 76,000 minus 1,320 minus 8,280 minus 5,000 minus 30,000. So next you have to pay to preference shareholders. So for preference shareholders you have to pay, see here it is there, correct? No. 10,000 into rupees 10, 1 lakh rupees you have to pay. You have 1 lakh rupees, then you can pay. If you have, yes, I think you have 1 lakh rupees, you can pay it, correct? No. Before that you have to see what is the commission on equity share. No. Okay, then you don't have any problem. You can pay to preference shareholders. 1 lakh you paid. Then pending dividend is there, 9%, 1 year pending. So on 1 lakh rupees, 9% you have to calculate, 9,000 rupees dividend is there, you are going to pay. You have paid it. Now the amount which is to be payable to equity shareholders, correct? No. Now you have to calculate 2,76,000 minus 1,320 minus 8,280 minus 5,000 minus 30,000 minus 1 lakh minus 9,000. So how much money remains? That much money you have to pay to equity shareholders. Within that portion only you have to calculate the commission, correct? No. Now you have, see here, come to the note. See here, you have now 1,22,400 rupees, correct? No. 1,22,400 is there. And how much money you have to pay to your shareholders? See here, equity shareholder, 20,000 rupees 10 is there. 20,000 into rupees 10, that amounts to your 2 lakh rupees you have to pay. But you don't have, you have only 1,22,400, correct? No. Yes. So this amount is to be paid, and from this amount only you have to calculate the commission. Amount which is distributed to equity shareholders, correct? No. Yes. 1,22,400 you have to pay, through which you also you have to pay commission. So 2% commission is to be paid. So now calculate. How to calculate that now? When the money is not sufficient. In this case, money is not sufficient. Correct, no? 2 lakh equity shares amount you have to pay, but you don't have that much money. Then the money is not sufficient means how to calculate the commission? 1,22,400 into 2% divided by 102. This formula is to be 102. This is to be done. So 1,22,400 into 2% into 2 divided by 102, that will be 2,400. So then the money remains again here after pay, that will be the answer will be 2,400. Correct? Yes, you have paid 2,400 now. After paying that, the money remains 1,20,000. So that much money only you can pay to your equity shareholders. For them, you have to pay generally here according to this 20,000. That means 2 lakh money you have to pay, but you don't have that much money. 2 lakh money you cannot pay. You pay only up to 1,20,000. 1,20,000 divided by your particular rupees per share, you can calculate. 1,20,000 divided by 20,000. So 6 rupees will be, can be payable. Only 6 rupees can be payable. Their investment is rupees 10, but you are going to pay only 6 rupees. So this way, 3 problems are there, and I will share these 3 snapshots to you in the groups also. You just go through it. And if you complete these 3 problems correctly, and if you are perfect in it, then easily you can solve your SEM exams 10 marks or case study 15 marks problem. So make it perfect, and also make, first you have to make perfect all those problems which we have solved during our class hours, that means before lockdown. You make those problems perfect first. Before that, the format you have to make it perfect, then after those problems and these 3 problems. Okay, so study it. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.